to RecordKingz. Shit, man, it's always something. You know, like, a lot of people used to always say, you know, like, Julian prices is too much. I never really thought of it like that, but, you know, you gotta spend money to make money. And if you think of it, you know, it's what he's paying for the records by the pound, which is, like, half of our money, because our money wasn't really worth shit. So, you know, for me, you know, when I buy records from Julian, it's a long, drawn-out process where it's, like, him sending me the covers, him sending me snippets, and it's, like, just about 25 records, it might take about 3 weeks, you know? And, you know, just even, you know, thinking of funny things, you know, like, I can remember, like, when Julian used to come out here, I thought it was kind of funny that, you know, we would meet downtown by some of the other record stores, but in order to buy the records from him, I would have to meet him around the corner because, you know, some of the stores, you know, they felt some kind of way with him. You know, can't just come in the store and just like, you know, he might be selling me the same records that their guy does, or, you know, the records I'm buying, you know, they might want. So, you know, I thought it was kind of funny that, you know, we have to sneak to the side, like, around the corner and, like, meet at different times to be going the same place. You know, I thought it was kind of crazy. To new producers and DJs like who's trying to come up in the game, I could definitely say that dealing with Julian, you can get you can get an abundance of things, whether if it's 12 inches, rap records, you know, samples, if you know any kind of music that you're looking for, he definitely has it, or he's able to get his hands on it. So whether if you're going on RecordKingz or Psycho, if you're able to meet him, you can definitely advance your, it will definitely be something that can advance your career. I would definitely recommend it. One thing that I think can change the game or even help, I think even publicly they need to, what you really need is like some sort of school show or something to teach a lot of the cats about the music and, you know, hip-hop to keep it, you know, to help it progress. You know, you don't know where you're going until you know where you've been at. For me, you know, I would basically be like an apprentice to, you know, the people I'm working with. So if I was with Finesse, I was with Finesse and showing them for about a good, you know, 3-4 years before I really made my first placement, which I learned a lot. A lot of these cats, you gotta really, you know, I think you should know and appreciate the music. When you know and appreciate the music, that's one thing that you can contribute to, you know, to help the game. And it's like, if I could do it, those are some of the things that the people that I encounter, that I try to push on up. So, you know, if I can help 1, 2, or 5 people to help teach them, you know, and hone their craft with, you know, producing, beat making, digging, etc., I believe if they go on it, they can teach another 5 or 10, which can actually help the game. It's like, you know, that's why I always say by at least 2013 and 2014, if hip hop is still around, it'll be where it needs to be, because a lot of younger cats are definitely looking to accomplish what they did in the 90s and not just for the money. Coming out to Europe, yeah, I should be there soon. I just put my turntables back up, you know, bought a Serato. You know, I'm just getting back into the swing of things, but hopefully soon, you know, maybe this year, this summer, this fall, you should see me out in Europe. You know, I don't rap, so more than likely I'll be DJing and trying to network and do different projects I can out there. Secret? I don't think there's no big secret, really. There's really just the love for the music and the drive to always be different. I believe you get out what you put in, you're only as good as your last. And, you know, for me, I try to make a lot of credible records with, you know, whoever, whether it's, you know, it's a new artist, for old artists, but as far as like staying in the game, I think a lot of that credit has to be with working with like a lot of the new artists, or maybe their first or second album, you know. Even though I work with Nas maybe on his 7th or 8th album, I work with Game on his 1st album, I work with 50 on his 2nd album, with Biggie on his 2nd album, when I work with OC, it was, you know, the bulk of his 1st album, Mike Toronto was his 1st album, so the ever-changing new guys who are coming in, those are the guys, a lot of those are the guys I love to work with, because making good records with them will definitely sustain your career. Shit, I think ever since I got my first world placement, which was, well, I can't even say my first placement. It took me a while to really get to like the wow of the music. And I would say like up until probably recently, the past few years, maybe 2004, 2005, and it's like, you know, when I've been in the game at least, you know, 9 years, something like that, made me be like, wow. Because after every record I took, you know, I always loved the music before producing, you know, I was DJ first. So, you know, I'd be doing different gigs, and it's like the transformation from a DJ to a producer. You know, you're making money, and it's like you love what you do, and that was always the best thing. And then looking back on the records that I've done, prior to the year when I was working with 50 Game, Nas, Remy, etc., etc., where I really look back and I was like, wow, this is something, you know, I can really mask what I was doing from, you know, times up, stress, you know, shit is real. Past Biggie's record, you know, I got a story to tell, past Whoa, and all the way up to like, you know, like I say, working with Beanie and the rest of them, all that was around the same time when I look back and I was like, wow, you know, it really hit me. And even, you know, as far as that, you know, the one thing that used to really inspire me, even before producing, was listening to like the Bomb Squad, like listening to them and how they put everything together, you know, from their albums to Ice Cube albums. And listening to the instrumental of, you know, America's Most Wanted, those were like the first records to be like, wow, you know, I want to do this. You know, so I think they were probably the most influential. And also, listening to Marley. Marley was a big influence because from what he did, from drum machines to finding the new loops, and it's like, you know, he went through an array of things, you know, and his growth and his career, and that kind of mind made me say like, wow, you know, this is something that's pretty exciting, and I can feel probably the same love that these guys have for what they did, you know, before I started. What's going on with Digging? Well, you know, AG's, you know, doing a solo project, you know, him and OC just finished a solo project. Finesse is doing production, Show's doing production, Diamond put out an album. And for me, you know, I'm doing beats and, you know, Fat Joe's doing his thing. So, you know, everybody's doing their own thing, you know, music-wise, you know, keeping, you know, their lights on, et cetera, et cetera. And as far as the reunion, you know, I don't rap, so I couldn't tell you none of that. Buckwild, RecordKingz, signing off for you and yours. Peace.